Hello student, good afternoon. Today we will start the new life cycle, that is Tinea solium. It is commonly called as flatworm or tapeworms. This is the flatworm or tapeworm. Both the side tapering body and segmented, elongated. And this is the parasite of vertebrates animals. Tinea solium belongs to class Cystoda. The number of this class are commonly known as tapeworm. All are endoparasites in the elementary canal and associated ducts of various vertebrates. Host. During their life cycles, one or two or more intermediate host. One is definitive host and one or two are the intermediate host of this Tinea solium, because its complete life cycle, completion of life cycle, it requires two hosts. One is definitive and one is intermediate host. Or two intermediate host. During their life cycles, one or two more intermediate host vertebrates and invertebrates are required, in which the tapeworms undergo a phase of development. The cystoid differ, however, from the members of other two classes, Turbellaria and Trematoda, means phylum Platyhelminthes has three classes, that is Cystoda, Turbellaria and Trematoda, and this Tinea solium is the cystoid parasites. In the complete absence of a digestive tract, digestive system is totally absent, digestive system or elementary canal, whole body absorb the food material from their host, because this parasite live in the intestine and other visceral organs. The present mainly related to Tinea solium, the pork tapeworm of man. It is commonly called as pork tapeworm because its host is, intermediate host is pig or pork. Classification, systematic classification. Phylum Platyhelminthes, class Cystoda, subclass Eucystoda, order Cyclophyllids, genus Tinea, species Solium. Habit and habitats. Tinea solium or pork worm, pork tapeworm, is commonly found in those parts of world where pork is eaten as a food. Without properly cooking, because improperly cooked flesh of pork or pig ingested by human beings, at that time that infection affected to the human beings or enters in the body of human beings, and its further life cycle also develop in the body of pig. It is found as in endoparasite in the gut of vertebrates host. One host is man and another is pig. Formerly, it was very common intestinal parasite in European, especially in some places of Europe. It is rare in many parts of the world, India, Philippines, North America. It is not at all found in Jewish and Mohammedan countries, as in those countries, eating of the flesh of pig is considered as an evil deed. This pig, flesh of pig, is not ingested by these two countries. External morphology, shape, size and color. The body is elongated and flattened dorsoventrally like a ribbon or tape. The body is narrow anteriorly and gradually broadens laterally towards posterior end. The size of adult worm varies from 3 to 5 meters, but a few are recorded to attain a length of about 8 meters. The body is usually opaque, white in color, but creamish, yellowish or grayish coloration is also common. Division of body. The body of Tinea is distinguished into three regions: scolex, neck and strobila. Body divided into three parts: scolex, neck and strobila. In scolex, four suckers are present, hooks are present, rostellum, rostellar hooks. Below the scolex, neck, below the neck, that is the immature segment, then mature segment, and then gravid segments. First, scolex. The scolex is the holdfast organs, which is generally considered the anterior end. There are two schools of thought concentrating the interpretation of the structure of tapeworms. Some consider the single scolex and connected proglottids to be single animal. Other consider each proglottids to be an individual. Hence, a single tapeworm is a colony of many individuals. Some helminthologists argue that the scolical end of the cystoid is actually convenience with the argument that scolex is the posterior end. Further, the more recent literature indicates the scolical end should be considered the anterior end. Scolex is a pear-shaped structure. Scolex is the pear-shaped structure, but is four-sided at the posterior part. It possesses a small terminal cone called the rostellum. Around the base of terminal cone or rostellum is a double row of curve pointed chitinous hooks, which are usually 28 in number but are sometimes between 22 to 32. Hooks are of two types. Hooks are two types. Long and small, both long and small hooks are arranged alternately. Long hooks are the approximately of 180 micron and short ones are of 130 microns dimension. Each hook consists of a base of guard by which it is fixed. Blunt projections are handle directed towards the apex and a conical outwardly directed blade. Rostellum is capable of slight protrusion and retraction. During the protrusion, hooks are directed forwards, but when rostellum is retracted, hooks are the directed backwards. Second is neck. Below the scolex, neck is present, very short neck, unsegmented. It is situated immediately posterior to the scolex. This is an unsegmented, poorly differentiated area that is generally narrower than the scolex and the strobila proper and is the continuously differentiating proglottids. That is why called the budding zone or area of proliferation that gives rise to immature proglottids. Strobila. The strobila, which constitutes the main bulk of body and is made up of chain of proglottids. There are about 800 to 1000 such proglottids. 800 to 1000 such proglottids. Proglottids are, it is called as segments also. Each proglottids bears a complete set of genitalia. Each proglottid bears a set of genitalia, means this is the hermaphrodite parasite. Both the reproductive system present in each and every segment or proglottids present in the cystoid parasite. It complete set of genitalia. This linear repetition of genital organs is termed as proglottids, proglottition. Since the proglottids are budded off from the neck region in a orderly succession, the youngest proglottids are towards the neck and the oldest proglottids are posterior most. Depending upon the development of genital organs, the proglottids are distinguished into three types. Immature proglottids, these are young, undifferentiated proglottids. Next to the neck region, the reproductive organs are either absent or in stages of development. Their width is more than the length. They comprises about 200 anterior proglottids. Mature or reproductive proglottids. The mature proglottids are sexually mature, considered consisting of a male and female set of reproductive organs They are usually as long as broad and are found in the middle of the body. They comprise about 450 proglottids. Tinea is protandrous, about 100 or 150 anterior mature proglottids, contains only male reproductive organs, and remaining 300 to 350 contains both the male and female reproductive organs. A mature proglottis is a complete reproductive unit in its own right and may undergo self or cross fertilization takes place. Third, gravid or ripe proglottids. Gravid or ripe proglottids means in the gravid proglottids only eggs, egg capsule and eggs are presented. After eggs, ovulation takes place and that reproductive also system also lost here, only egg or egg capsule are present. These are found in the posterior part of the body. These are characterized by possession of a large, highly branched uterus filled with a developing embryo. The rest of the genital organs have already disappeared. Genital organs or reproductive system, both male as well as female, are disappeared from them after the performing either function, performing their function. They are longer than broad. The posterior most proglottids are cut from the body and are expelled out of host body along its fissures. This process is separate of proglottids is known as the apolysis. Okay, thank you.